Leading off our discussion tonight, LaTosha Brown, co-founder of Black Voters Matter Fund. She met today with Vice President Kamala Harris. Thank you very much for joining us tonight. Before we get to today, I just want to cover tomorrow. You were at the Hart Senate office building. Why didn't you get arrested? What did Carswin Beatty do that you didn't do?
Well, we all did the same thing. I think that part of it is that there were nine people who were in the position where they got arrested. And others of us, we had to make sure that they were taken care of, that they had their bail, that, you know, that is an organized strategy, that part of what we wanted to do is we went in the spirit of peace, but we also went to really raise our voice and say that we're going to be relentless around getting voting rights secured in this country. That is not something that, no, we cannot wait. You know, as we're looking at what is happening right now, we're seeing attacks all across this country on the county level, on the state level, and on the federal level, and that we wanted to make sure our voices are heard, that we're going to be relentless in fighting for voting rights, and not one senator, two senators, or even the Senate is going to stop us, particularly on the eve, you know, of what we're talking about celebrating John Lewis.
Well, you know, just to be clear, no senators tried to stop you, right? I mean, you went into that vast canyon of a lobby, and no one came out and objected to you being there, no, other than the Capitol Police, right?
No one objected for us being there. Actually, we were able to go in. We were able to sing. We went very peacefully because what we wanted to do is we wanted to use our democratic right of protesting to really say that we were upset about what is happening and that, in fact, we are going to fight for voting rights. You know, I do think that the response was very different, though, because we came in a different kind of spirit than even those that came on January the 6th. And yet, even in the context of us coming in that way, we were immediately arrested, which did not happen to the people on January the 6th. So, you know, in this space, what we're saying is that we need For the People Act and the John Lewis Voter Advancement Act, that what we're saying is Black voters and Black women wanted to send this message loud and clear, that because we showed up and showed out in last election, what we're seeing is punitive measures all across this nation to create a system and an environment of fear. And we're not going to stand for it. We're going to be relentless. We believe we're going to have civil disobedience until we get the passage of the For the People Act and the John Lewis Voter Advancement Act.
I want to get your advice for a guest coming up later in this program, Senator Amy Klobuchar, who's the chair of the Senate Rules Committee. She's going to take her committee to Georgia to have a field hearing, which is something that that committee almost never does. They haven't done it in at least 20 years, a field hearing outside of Washington about voting rights in Georgia. What should Chairwoman Klobuchar be focusing on? Where should she be aiming her questions when she's at that hearing in Georgia?
You know, I think there's three things. I think we need to really understand kind of not just the urgency, but how this is a layered approach, that how the administrative process, while we're talking about some things, even in Georgia, around, you know, not being able to give out water, those pieces, but some of the most egregious is how they're weaponizing the administrative process. You know, it was just on a few days ago where the Secretary of State, who's a Republican, Raffensperger, actually has called for the resignation of the election officials in Fulton County, the most populous county in a heavily majority-minority county, Black county in the state. That this is the same county that Trump wanted to actually, he said that he wanted to turn over the election, and it was counted three times and still came up where the votes were correct. You know, and in that process, what he's also saying is there are plans to take over the election. So they're weaponizing the administrative process to undermine. You know, what we think is one that actually comes down to really be able to get to the bottom of really hearing about what is happening on the county level and on the state level, really be able to hear people and their frustrations of voters and how this is creating a barrier of having access to the ballot. But I also think that we cannot ignore the elephant in the room. The bottom line is unless we address and deal with the filibuster has to end. And so we even need Amy Klobuchar, we need all of the senators really to really put pressure, you know, on whether that's President Biden, the Senate, that we are going to have to end the filibuster to move forward. There has been no good faith on the side of the Republicans that we can even imagine that we're going to have 10 votes that are going to actually help that pass.
Let's listen to more of what the vice president had to say today.
Let's be clear, not about any one racial group or gender group. This is about all Americans. This is not an issue about Democrats versus Republicans. This is about Americans. And this group of national leaders are very clear about that. This is a fight for all people, regardless of who they voted for in the last election or who they vote for in the next election.
What was your reaction to that?
I mean, I think she's absolutely right. I think what we have to really recognize, kind of the nuance of what is happening, is that Black and brown voters are being targeted in these communities, but that the impact of that will not just impact Black voters or Democratic voters, it will actually undermine democracy for all of us. And so I think that's a true statement. I think that's why we have to see this as the most critical and urgent issue in protecting democracy in this country. That the bottom line is, literally, when we're affecting voting rights for a few, you're actually impacting it for all of us. And so what is happening right now is actually criminal. Matter of fact, it is an abuse of power. And I think that is political corruption. When you have a party that is in power that says that the way that they're going to maintain power by literally marginalizing or silencing some of the citizens of that nation, that is the definition of political corruption. And so we have to really recognize the far-reaching impact of what is happening right now, even though many of these attacks have been targeted at Black and brown voters.
LaTosha Brown ordered out of the Hart Senate office building yesterday and welcomed into the White House today. Thank you very much for joining us tonight.
Thank you, Lawrence, for having me. Always great to be here.